Hey there! So recently I've made a video about cross stitch basics, so if you know nothing about the craft or you don't know how to start, then check that out first, because today I want to talk about some tips that I have for you to make your cross stitching look even better. Cross stitching is not complicated at all, but there are some things that you can keep in mind to make it look really flawless. And so I have 5 tips for you to step up your cross stitch game, and let's just start. So the first thing is to make your crosses always the same direction. So one cross consists of 2 stitches. In fact, there is this like a slash and a backslash. And when you make it the same direction always, for example, first slash and then backslash, it gives it this unified look that all the cross stitchers around the world are looking for. And it really changes a lot, trust me. So to obtain this, you can either go stitch by stitch like normally you would do, but then you would use a little bit more of your floss. But it's okay, it's not that big of a difference. But you can also make half of the stitch, so for example a slash on a big area, like on an entire line on your projects, or bigger area. Of course, it's only possible if your project has bigger areas or lines of the same color, but like I said, then you can do the first half of the cross on the entire area and then go back over it. This way you not only use less of your floss, but also you don't have to focus that much, because you only have to count your pattern for half of the stitching only when you do these slashes. And when you go back, you don't have to focus that much, because you only go over the stitches you already made, so you can watch something or listen to a podcast or something, and you don't have to think about it. Second tip is to never go through a floss that is already stitched on your project. And what I mean is, when your pattern is dense and you have to go through the same wall over and over, like you're gonna have up to 4 stitches using the same hole in your canvas, then you have to fit all the floss there in that hole, and it can be a little bit tricky, and I am guilty of making this mistake sometimes. But you really have to try not to go through a floss that is already there, not to separate the strands from a stitch that is already there, because it is so visible. But it can be kind of tricky, so the way to avoid it is to think about the tension you use when you make stitches. So obviously you don't have to go too hard, because then you can distort the canvas, but also to avoid these mistakes of dividing a floss that is on your canvas already, you don't want your stitches to be too loose, because then it will be really hard not to put your needle through the floss. So yeah, really think about the tension that you use, but also just focus on avoiding this mistake. So when you see that you're going through a floss, you see that you are separating strands that are there, just go back and try again until you make it the right way. It can be frustrating sometimes, so this is why I don't always focus on it that much, but especially with darker colors, it's really visible. And the first thing is, use the right thickness needle. So it might seem that as long as you have a cross stitch or a tapestry needle, the one that has a rounded tip, then you're good to go. But it's a little bit more complicated. Well, it's not complicated, but you know what I mean. It can be a little bit tricky. You don't want your needle to be too thin, because then it would keep falling out of the hole when you want to reach it on the other side, and this can be really, really frustrating. But also you don't want it to be too thick, because then you will just make the holes in your canvas bigger, and you will distort a canvas a little bit, and it's really visible when the holes are just too big. So the proper needle can really make a big difference, and my tip is to just purchase a set of needles, different sizes, so we can really test what works for you the best, and you can really use different density canvas, and you will be all set for all different possibilities. And yeah, just test if the needle stays in the hole in your canvas and if it doesn't make it bigger. My fourth tip is to untwist your thread from time to time. It's a really easy tip, but it can really make a difference. But it's easy to forget, and I do forget about it very often actually. So when you stitch, then you naturally twist your needle a little bit, and over time it can be more and more twisted, and it will really show that your strands are not parallel in the stitch, but they are a little bit twisted. It doesn't look that good, and the floss doesn't look that fluffy, if you know what I mean. So yeah, the easy way to avoid it is to just untwist your thread, like I said. So what you want to do is to just, from time to time, when you see your needle, your thread starts to get twisted, just hold your project and let your needle loose, like just hang by itself, and it will just untwist by itself. And I'm not sure how often you should do it, because I'm not sure how quickly it gets twisted. I just look at the thread and how it looks, and I don't measure time or stitches, and yeah, just untwist it as often as you need. Maybe you will twist your needle more or maybe less than me, and yeah, the frequency will be different. So just look on your thread how it looks. And the last, fifth tip is to check your back of your project from time to time to see if it looks good and if there are no tangles there. So that doesn't necessarily affect the front of your work, but we want the backs of our pieces to look good too, right? You will probably get some tangles from time to time, and if you are too far away from the stitch where it gets tangled, it's not really easy to just undo it, because you would have to push the excess floss through all the stitches that you made. So it's really not worth trying. Just every now and then, maybe every few stitches, look at the back, make sure that there are no tangles. If there are, then just undo them and pull your floss through. If you do it often enough, then it will be possible to push it through all the stitches, so it would be just like nothing happens there. Usually you would probably feel that all of a sudden your thread is a lot shorter, so you can figure out that there probably is getting tangled, but sometimes you won't just feel it. So then the best thing to do is to just control it. It does not take a lot of time, so I think it's really worth doing and just making a back of your project pretty too. Okay, that's it. They are all about making our projects look more pretty, but I have some tips that I will make another video about. Not about making it look pretty, but making the process easier and more pleasing. So yeah, if you have any tips on how to make our cross stitch projects look better, then leave them in the comments below for me and for other people to learn. And if you like that video, then make sure to click the thumbs up, and for more cross stitch but also sewing related content, consider subscribing. And I think that's it for today, so see you in the next one. Bye.